for this.
What in God's name is going on in here? What was that ruckus?
What ruckus?
I was just in my office and I heard a ruckus.
Could you describe the ruckus, sir?
Turn the fucking beat up!
What is that? What is that? What is that noise?
What noise?
Really, sir, there wasn't any noise.
Let's create.
Nah, not yet.
I'm ready to create now.
Nah, not yet. Hold on.
No, let's create now.
Alright, y'all, we up in this thing. It's another episode of the Skeeters. What up, though?
What up, what up, what up?
How you feeling?
Feeling good, man. Feeling good.
Is motherhood, when are you out yet?
Nah, I was ready for this, man. You know, I got myself ready. And then, I mean, I grew up with sisters, so.
Born in it.
I had to deal with it.
We know that. You ain't got to give us the whole backstory all over again, nigga.
I'm not. I was just saying. I already know I'm prepared for it. Not 100% prepared.
I'm sure.
But I'm prepared at least 40%.
All right. Well, that's good to know because you got to stay prepared. I wanted to ask you, though. We got to get off into the shenanigans because so we about a week out from our anniversary, our fourth married anniversary. And we got to say it like that because we've been together for going on 10 years, damn near.
Mm-hmm.
We've been together damn near 10 years, bro. So when people be like, y'all still young, y'all got shot the fuck up. Okay. Any plans?
Holding it down here, you know, dinner, movie, baby.
the usual. You bought at home. I got my anniversary gift early. And it was cool, though. You made me feel like a little ass kid, though.
You
man.
Got just two of your anniversary gifts.
Well, no, I got a new backpack for work with my laptop bag and all that. I carry a backpack. I don't carry no suitcase or none of that shit. And then she got me a new lunchbox. So now I feel like the old ass nigga. I was walking to the car on the way out from work today, and I was like, I done turned into that old ass lunch pail ass nigga. Like.
No, but I mean, your lunch, you had a full lunch, right? And it was all nice with a good temperature, though. You ain't got no plastic bag just rolling up there like
looking
just ghetto.
Yeah.
Exactly. So
my whole career, I've been looking ghetto, though. I've been working for 11 years. I've always either bought lunch or showed up with the little plastic bag.
Well, you ain't ghetto no more.
We took Chick-fil-A salad containers like they was Tupperware for the longest.
Yeah, now you got real Tupperware.
Balling. That's how you know niggas elevated. Got money. Niggas got money. Niggas got a real lunchbox.
Exactly.
And then your gifts. Your gifts will be on the way soon, too. So.
Ew, I have gifts.
Yeah. Well, I mean, let's be real. Now, yeah. Okay, anniversary and birthdays and stuff. Yeah, niggas turn up. But, like, most of the time, it'd be, what you want? Pick it out. How much is it?
Yeah. All right. Like, so that means that way, at least you know you're getting the person something that they want.
Yeah, because I'm not big on surprises. I'm pretty much, I know what I want, so buy me that. I would rather that than somebody just buy me. It's the thought that counts. Because I told you how I feel about when people give like that. I don't mind the gift, but did you put thought into the gift for what you wanted or what you thought that the other person would have?
Exactly.
Which that's where the thoughtfulness is supposed to come in. Or don't do it at all. Like, I would rather you not give me a gift than to give me some shit that I don't want. That's just how I feel. Like, keep it to yourself. Because that's wasteful.
Yeah, I don't like stuff that people don't, that I don't want, that people give. And it goes right in my closet.
Yeah. So we got that together. It's probably, like you said, probably going to do some cooking. I read, I was watching an article. It was like, couples need to cook together. And it's like, nah, like, they haven't seen you in the kitchen. So, like, either I can cook or you can cook. But we can't cook together.
Yeah, nah, because I clean as I cook.
Yeah, and I cook, but like, I be in there, I'm on the phone, I'm listening to music, I'm moving around and stuff. You like, you think that you a sous chef or something.
But no, I talk as I go, but I gotta clean as I cook because I can't stand all them extra pots in the way. And then when it's done, it's like, no, I just got the pots that I gotta serve out of. Nothing extra.
I'm sure. again, like a sous chef. You be up there with the little towel wrapped around the wrist and shit. Like, nigga, if you don't, who you think you is? Emerald Agassi?
Hey, man, I be cooking.
What was the man with the dirty fingernails? Was it like Chef Mario or something?
No, I don't remember.
He was an Italian dude. So back in the day when cooking shows are still big, but it was a dude. And he, it was Emeril Lagasse because, you know, he had the punchlines and shit. Bam, take it up a notch. Bam, bam. And then there was another guy, but he ain't had that flair to him. And then my granny was like, I don't like watching him, baby. He got dirty fingernails. It don't look like he washed his hands before he start cooking. And I was like, Granny, man, you just talking. So one day we was watching it and we paused it. And this before like DVR and all that. And we paused it and I got up, you know, walked to the other side of the room. I'm like, damn. No, actually, we did have DVR. This was before streaming, my bad.
Okay.
Streaming and all that. Walked over.
Dang, this was the ancient days.
Yeah, and I was like, damn. Well, my granny was still alive. So it was at least 10 years ago, which is ancient these times. And I was like, damn, this nigga do got dirty-ass fingernails. And I was like, well, granny, maybe it's seasoning and stuff. Because, you know, when I make my Mediterranean, the seasoning get underneath there, and my nails be all yellow and everything for, like, at least a day afterwards. So they probably look at me like, this nigga got jaundice? Is he on heroin or something? No.
I'm listening to your story.
Okay. I guess not then. So you, but you still not hip to dog after I just explained to you that he was the dirty Italian dude with the finger.
I don't know him. I know Chef Ramsay.
Oh, that nigga just yell at niggas. I could do that shit. Well, no, you do that shit. You could be Chef Ramsay. Shut the fuck up. Get out of my cousin. This is poo. Look at it. Eat it. Would you feed that to your parents?
Yeah, see, that's who I know in his cooking show. I don't know these other folks.
Yeah. So we may have to bring out the... Can you eat red meat now? Because I know you've been changing your diet and everything now.
I can, but it's not a preference. Like, I had the spare ribs our weekend. I don't like... Weekend date, but...
I don't like when you do the spare ribs because that, when you do the spare ribs, like, it only be a little bit of meat on the bone. It'd be mostly bone. It'd be like,
well,
bruh.
Yeah, because you know that's mainly what the spare ribs are. You get a half a rack.
So why do we continue to eat that?
Because there's some meat in the middle of it. It'd be some meat on
nigga,
there.
You just paid $26 for some beef nuggets.
Beef nuggets.
Side note. Complete tangent. You see Popeye's about to have chicken nuggets?
Chicken nugget. I'm surprised, but honestly, I'm surprised Popeye's ain't been had chicken nuggets.
Would you try it?
Hell no. I'm done with Popeye's.
Guess what? I'm not done with Popeye's. I am sharpening my knife after this show. After this episode, I will be sharpening my knife because everybody knows Popeye's tastes better when you stab a nigga for it. Okay? They talk about the Popeye's chicken sandwich. Oh, it just don't hit the way that such and such, blah, blah. Nah. You right. They don't hit because you didn't stab nobody for that. You got to stab somebody, pull it out, and rub the blood on the bun and then eat it.
I guess.
With the pickle.
I'm not a fan of Popeyes.
I like Popeyes. That's some hood shit.
You and all the other chunky people in the world.
Hey, just because you losing your weight and you snapping back into shape don't mean you got to make fun of me. Okay?
I'm not making fun of you.
And I wanted to ask you because you was like, all right, you said something in passing yesterday, but I felt like it was some fuck shit, but I just let it slide. But you was like, we about to start up P90X tomorrow. And I was like, the fuck we is?
What? You wasn't trying to work out with me?
Not no P90X. And then how you going to do that with the baby?
She goes right there in her swing.
You don't have an out. She don't like that swing no more. She was in that swing two times.
She likes her swing. She's still chilling it. So she was chilling in her swing. I was starting today. And then it said, baby was like, the fuck you think you're
doing? Exactly. And it was over.
She only let me get to the through the warm-up.
The warm-up is only 2 minutes.
And she was like, the fuck you think you're doing? Because I turned around and she was looking at me. She was just cooing. And I was like, okay, cool. She good. She ain't finna mess with me. Then she broke out. And I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah, she really was like, turn that shit off because dude was annoying. Mind you, we doing P90X. So these videos is at least like... 17
from the 90s.
Yeah, it's 17 years old, bro. Like it's lo-fi, it's all fuzzy, and it's come on now, you can do it, lift your buns. These corny little puns and punchlines and stuff, man. Yeah. All types of shit. And what's old girl?
I'm gonna do conga.
But no, you, and so this the thing too, and that's why I kind of bristled at it when you was like, we gonna start it back up again, because we are quoted as saying, we finished 13 weeks prior to you being pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
Like exactly like the 13th week is when we found out you were pregnant. So really, wait, you was 8 weeks pregnant. So 8 of those weeks you was pregnant when you was doing it.
Yeah.
You want to tuck the baby underneath your shirt and
No, actually, what I was trying to do, because you know how we got the little carrier thing, like the little front pack carrier.
Now, when you do plyometrics, what's gonna happen when you gotta do a plyo push-up?
Yeah, I can't.
Which brings me to my point. You were skipping all the hard shit when we was doing
it. I was not.
You was.
I was.
You
not. Was.
You were like, babe, let's do it. And then I just wouldn't
do as many sets. You would. I did them, but I wouldn't do as many sets.
If it was 12 exercises, you would do about 4 of them.
No, don't even lie on me. Don't even lie on me. Don't
on the push-ups, because that push-ups one is all push-ups.
I didn't do that damn sliding push-ups because I'm not finna do that and slide and bust my face.
Did you do the diamond push-ups?
I tried them. I did 3.
Exactly. So how it look when I'm over here doing 12 and I look over and you chilling?
I did 3 and then I just go back to the regular push-ups. Mm-hmm. I go back to the regular. I do 10 of those and you continue on with your diamond and whatever other fuck shit you was doing. Your side to side.
The one frog arm.
Leap. Yeah. You lay down and roll over and push back up.
Some of that push-ups. Shit was bullshit. Some of those work out.
And I just do regular push-ups the whole time.
But you were skipping them.
I was just doing regular push-ups. I guess. So I was done.
We in a bigger apartment now, so we got more space.
Yeah, but now your neighbor's going, what the fuck are y'all doing?
Nah, hey, that one lady downstairs can't talk. She make the most noise. Okay, I don't know what the hell they got going on down there now, but a couple nights in a row, we done heard her getting thrashed.
Yeah, she be getting banged.
She was getting out. Bashed and thrashed. She was getting flipped and dipped.
And it don't just be like, no, 9, 10 o'clock. It be like 3, 4 in the morning. You'd be like, damn.
I caught them one day. So I was walking the dog at like, because you know I get up super early now. Mm-hmm. And I guess, like I said, she be getting her fix. It'd be early. It'd be 4 or 5 in the morning or whatever. So it's like 5:30, 5:45. I'm outside walking the dog. And, because it's a narrow stairway, so I let whoever coming down, I let go, like, and then I walk up.
Okay.
It was some old, like, grandpa-looking ass nigga. Like, he looked like one of the more retired niggas, and he was, like, taking the walk of shame down the thing. I was like, okay, grandpa was in there, man. He was in there doing the frog, man.
He be getting his Viagra and be smashing her.
Man, he on Blue Chew. Blue Chew is the new shit now. He was in there doing, he was frog splashing her ass,
man.
He be
good for hours.
That nigga was up in there. Let me hit it from the side. Just one more time.
I got more to go. Come on.
Now I gotta leave. It's 5:30.
What are you
gonna
do with this hard thing here?
he did everything.
Because look, I'm telling you, because they be all in the bathroom because you can hear the doors closing and you can tell when somebody's in the bathroom because bathrooms always echo.
He told her, he was like, you want macaroni for breakfast?
I guess I do.
Give me some.
Wow.
That's how you make babies.
Exactly.
I think our last anniversary is when didn't we do the math in that when you got pregnant?
No, it had to be a little after because it had to be at least September, August, September.
Yeah, but they say you fertile now because you got the all clear for us to begin sexual intercourse again. And Neezy talking about getting another one. Yeah. She ain't even got a handle on London yet.
No, we have to wait. London has to be at least 18 months. We got to enjoy London.
A year. That was 18 month shit. A year. 12 months is a year.
But she's
year.
A little over. We a have year. To do a little over a year.
18 months.
Yeah. Because we got to enjoy her.
I don't know. If we hurry up, will we count as far as getting that stimulus check for next year?
Well, we can't fill the one that you have to fill out because if their baby was born by the 11th of June, they say you can fill out the form. You can't. We don't qualify for it.
No, is that true, though? Are they really giving out stimulus checks for niggas with kids?
They're now, yeah, starting on the 15th. Yeah. So people who were previously getting the stimulus check with their kids, those are going to be the ones who still gets it. They're going to get an extra $250 to $300 depending on the age of your kid.
So what you're saying is we got to go to a park.
No, because they ain't even going to be on our taxes. It's kids that's on your taxes.
This is not our kids. We already out the gate. We chalked, right? We can go to the park and find somebody with kids and hit them over the head and take their stimulus check.
Sure.
You gotta be a crazy motherfucker to be out here robbing, nigga. This is cryptocurrency and digital stuff. Give me your money, nigga. It's all on my debit card. Give me your debit card. I cut it off.
You know the new Robin is just hacking folks' account and just taking their money.
Scamming it.
They out here doing scamming like it and blaming it too. Just
we finished that series. Can we talk about that for a second? I don't think we talked about it on here. So we finished Startup. It was on Crackle at first, and then it was about 5 years old, but they brought it to Netflix. So
it was a good show.
A lot of plot holes towards the end, as with most shows. After about season 2, it started getting stupid. It didn't get too stupid, but you could tell they were setting up to start doing some stupid shit.
Yeah.
Couple things. Them bringing in the one agent over the other agent. The other agent, I thought he was going to be more of a force. The Rask dude who played on Agents of Shield, not Agents of Shield, but like played in Black Panther and all that.
Yeah.
He was trash. Cause he like even what the, like the third episode, spoiler alert, he kills his partner.
Yeah,
like terrible. The third episode, like it ain't even build up nothing. Like it ain't even explore their relationship. No, he killed her on like the first date, second date. Like,
and then the way he killed her, and then tried to dispose of her body was just stupid. It's like you didn't use common sense. He threw her in the ocean or a lake with all these alligators, but he threw her inside of the suitcase. He didn't even open the suitcase so the alligators could at least get to the body.
But he was smart enough to use hamburger meat to draw the gators to the thing, so he half thought it.
Halfway.
Which tells you about this show, right? It's a lot of good premise, but a lot of halfway shit, right? Primarily, so there the girl Izzy, when she's, and I read this because, you know, we always go through and like investigate and read shit. When the girl was voted out of her shares of GenCoin when she got fucked out of her company the first time, mm-hmm. it was still a buyout. She was still supposed to have money. She wasn't supposed to go back to being dirt ass poor and not having nothing. It should have been a substantial amount of money. She should have at least had a milli.
Like, she was just stupid.
Yeah, she was dumb and emotional all over the place.
Because again, she don't be reading our contract. She just signed.
She just signed that shit. But
and again, you know, we've learned from South Park. You just signed shit. No. You did not read the fine print. Look, it said if you accept these terms and conditions, you will suck my dick.
Hey, while you talking, we was up in that hospital, man. You be signing away your firstborn child. Remember, they was up here talking about some using the placenta for stem cell research and this and that. If not, we just gonna throw it away. Then they brought the other lady. We was like, yeah. We'll speak to her. Then we was talking about it while they was waiting on her to come in. As soon as she walked in, we let her do her speech. She was like, nah, we good. She was all disappointed.
I'm
like,
yeah, but I sat there and I was reading through all my paperwork because I said, look, y'all ain't finna just have me sign and shit.
Well, what you don't know is they was just gonna dig that shit out the trash and use it anyway.
Of course.
Just wanted to have consent. They're going to get it one way.
They don't even throw it in the trash. Remember, they just put it inside like a little bucket and they take it out the room.
And then hand it off to the people.
Yeah, that's all they do.
So now it's going to be a clone of our baby somewhere over in China and
looking
stuff.
Looking just like you.
Her name going to be Yandan.
Going to be somebody, look, that look like Lo.
Makasau.
then, better not ever run into that baby because then I'm going to have to kick you in the chest.
Yeah, that baby going to kick you back. She's Chinese, bro.
I said, I'm going to kick you in the chest.
What? Nah. So we talked about a stimulus check. Hospital. No. There was another thing. You had brought this up. It was an interesting point. And I wanted to bring it to the show because you was talking about, we was talking about startup. But Izzy, like, she was supposed to be like the hero of the show and all that. But it made me think of something because, like, you know, women's empowerment, we got a lot going on. We trying to like promote, you know, positivity and empowerment amongst women. And we was talking about this as far as you was like, you said that like women being handy in the house or something like that. What was that topic?
Yeah. So basically, it was just a little topic that was going around, like one of those little. Not nation, but one of those little residential articles, you know, that you have. So it was, does it make a man less of a man when his wife or significant other, girlfriend, blah blah blah, is handy? And a lot of people were saying no, it doesn't. But you know, you always get that crowd. It was like 40% of men and women said yes, it makes a man less of a man when he is not the handy one in the household. But I don't feel that way because, one, you have a lot of women who are like, I want it done a certain way and you can't do it my way, so I'm gonna do it my own self. And a lot of women, like how
I am a strong black woman,
like how I grew up with your dads make you handy, you know. Mm-hmm. Your dad then showed you how to check your oil, change your tire, how to build this dang on blasted dresser, how to fix this. Because I mean, you know me, in a heartbeat I'll go and fix anything. I got this little toolkit here.
Because with that car shit, you was like, oh yeah, you gotta do this now. I'm like, and I just go on my wallet and be like, I'm gonna call AAA. Like, save me a whole.
You lift that hood, yeah, you check your oil,
and you gonna be out there all damn day. It's too hot for that shit. It's 95 degrees outside, and you up here trying to play fucking Bob the Builder. the fuck out of here.
Sometimes you got to pump the brake.
Did you light your cigarette to go with that? I'm calling AAA. I'm about to be on my phone until AAA get here. Now, part of that, I'm spoiled because, like, all the old heads at AAA, like, all the directors and all this and that was, like, my godparents and like, my mom and all that. So, I don't have that 45-minute to an hour wait like everybody else. You was with me a couple of times when our cars used to break down. Them AAA people, like, they be there in fucking 15 minutes.
Yeah.
They be like, it's like they had something on file. Like, oh, that's such and such nephew. Like, all right, come get them.
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nay Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
But yeah.
They do. They be moving quick. You got special treatment on that.
Exactly. But I say it like this. I don't feel any less of a man because I'm one of those people that subscribe to the time equals money paradigm or whatever. Right. So, for instance, when it come to cars, I could sit around and fuck around and tinker with it, or I could just take it somewhere and have it done. Right. Yeah.
I feel you.
Because remember when we used to go to that one, the one car place, well, we had two different ones we was going to, but they'll take your car, but they'll hold on to that shit for 4 days. So it's like, all right, we best get it over there now so that I can have it back before, you know what I'm saying? By the time it's time to go back to work versus sitting up here and trying to fuck around with it all day, then get it over there on Sunday and they're not going to be able to get me my car back till Wednesday and I got to find a way to work on Monday and Tuesday.
Exactly.
Let's get this shit over there on Thursday. I'm off on Friday. I at least have my car back by Sunday morning and then all will be good. Like,
yeah, no, I know how you feel because my uncle is like that. My uncle, he goes, I went to school for this, that, and the third.
Yeah.
And they went to school to fix on cars. So that's their job. Yep. I'll pay them to do their job.
Expertise. That's what, that's another thing, though. For instance, I could sit up here and be like, I'm going to do my own hair, which is admirable. You can be a DIYer, right? Mm-hmm. A do-it-yourselfer, right? But if you want it done on an expert level, you're going to pay an expert.
Exactly.
Right? You could try to braid your own hair. I know most women like grow up learning how to braid hair to an extent, but if you got certain special hairstyles and stuff that you want, instead of sitting up there fucking around with it and this and that, or it may be a hard to reach place like in the back of your head, you can get it up to a certain point. You're going to go to the stylist. Exactly. Or you're going to go to somebody to do it. Same thing like with a podcast and stuff. You can buy all the equipment and set it up, and when you wondering why it's all types of reverb and your shit echoing and your mix come out all bad and stuff, you can go to a studio or you can pay an actual podcast producer. Like, pay an expert. Marketing, same thing. Like, you're paying for people for their expertise, my
nigga. Exactly.
So if you got it, spend it. It's handyman out here, and I know it's like, I'm gonna save some money. Bro, I'd rather pay somebody to do it right and get it done with than to me try to do it and fuck it up and then blow the whole house up.
Exactly.
Okay.
Because if they break it, shit, they got to buy it and fix it.
Exactly. And that's what insurance is for.
Break it. Oh, shit. I just got to go buy another one.
I'm paying way
and
too much money.
You just lost the money.
You paying all this money in insurance, nigga. You better get your money's worth. That's what it's for.
Exactly.
But I understand the whole strong, independent woman thing because your show, you've been on your binge your binge tip, so you find the different shows. I walk in the room, we watching Reba, my dog.
I love Reba.
Clearly. Tell us why you love Reba.
I finished it now.
Did it end stupid? Because again, a lot of those shows started to end stupid and run off the rails.
No, actually, Reba was good through the whole time. Only thing I did not like, because you know, Reba is Southern, and the show takes place in Houston, Texas.
Which I didn't originally know that. We ain't know nothing about no Houston growing up. Like,
Reba is from Oklahoma, but then they moved to Houston, Texas. So, and her ex-husband, if you know the show, her ex-husband is a dentist.
Mm-hmm.
And then he has a mistress that he ended up sleeping with who was his dental assistant.
Okay.
Anyway, so she got her house. They got their household. But basically, it's like co-parenting and then existing.
Because they lived up the street from each other.
Yeah,
didn't they
live next door from each
this
other.
This shit sound like All of Us.
Yeah, it's like the white version of it. But I think Reba came first.
It did. They probably used the. It looked like they used the same damn house. That house.
They used the same house.
That was the Hughley's house too.
That house has also been on Good Luck Charlie from Disney Channel. Yeah. They used the whole sets. But what I was saying, what I do not like about a lot of the TV shows as I've been going back watching, is when they basically try to do like a crossover and they had a black folks come in. On Reba,
what black folks did they have?
They had
Melanie and them from the game.
No, they had Harriet from Family Matters, the mom.
Trash.
So basically, she during this Harriet? Time, no, she just played another family.
Okay.
So basically, this was like the episode of Boondocks when Hurricane Katrina happened in New Orleans and they all came to Houston. So these folks all came to Houston. They was living.
It was out during that time?
Yeah.
Shit. Okay.
They all came to Houston.
So they played the ghetto ass New Orleans folks.
Yes.
Who needed a place to stay.
Yep. And they all was like all 20 of them was living in Reba's house. They had a line for the bathroom.
Wait, how did she know Reba? Reba just opened her house to them?
No. The son, her grandson went to school with Reba's younger son, Jake.
Okay.
And he goes, yeah, you and your family can come over after school.
And they all believed that. Instead of let's talk to your mom first, being some niggas, they just showed up.
But Barbara Jean, which is the stepmom, she also was like, yeah, come on over. You can come to Reba house. Why you didn't invite them to your house, Barbara Jean?
She knew what she was doing, those but niggers.
She invited them all to Reba house, and then they started braiding her hair. Then they started cooking. But what I don't like is they had them like, yeah, you know, because we's lost everything in Hurricane Katrina, we's gonna get our house back. And I was like, everybody don't talk like that. Stop trying to portray black people like that. That's what pisses me off.
Yeah.
You know, you have your directors and they write the script and make black folks talk like that. We don't talk like that.
Well, I don't know. You talk to people from Louisiana. Why, what's up, Reba? My woday.
But everybody don't say, I's gonna get this now. I's gonna go down to the office. They don't talk like that. That's slave talk.
Well, you know, back then, we weren't represented well in sitcoms. It was a bit of hyperbole.
Yeah.
It was a lot of exaggeration and niggerdom. That's why they canceled South Central.
Now, going back and watching Living Single, it's actually really, I knew it was really good. But you go back, it's also educational, too. They do a lot of black empowerment on there.
Yeah. That was a good show. They say a friend that was based off, that was like black Friends or Friends was based off of them. I didn't really get that because it was, Friends was like the way it was proportioned, right? It was three dudes and three chicks.
Yeah.
This one was like four chicks and two dudes. So it wasn't really even. And they didn't really date each other. I mean, they did, but not really.
Yeah. But then also, too, with Living Single, it shows like what they're trying to do with the women empowerment too.
Yeah.
Like strong black woman, strong sisterhood.
Yeah.
You know?
Which every show now is for women, and you got the crazy one, the bougie one, the ditzy one, and then
yeah,
the
strong, if y'all ain't watched it,
one.
Run the World is actually good. It's basically like a black Sex in the City.
Is it better than Sisters?
Oh yeah, it's damn sure.
Is it better than Girlfriends?
Nah. I wouldn't say better than Girlfriend, but it's like they're trying to be on that same level as Girlfriend.
Again, you can find you three more chicks and then y'all can do a show.
I've been trying to do that for the longest. Folks don't be loyal and folks don't be consistent. Because I was trying to do a YouTube series, so
You trying to collab?
I've been trying to do that for the longest. I was actually trying to do a YouTube series when I was serious all about it. And I was like, look here, so we can promote Naturally Nay, I will do everybody's hair.
What will it be called?
I said, like, it'll be, what'd I say, Wives of Houston or...
Oh, that's original.
But you gotta have a Houston chapter,
I got an idea. Reba.
Shut up, nigga.
Ooh.
It'll be Neezy, because then everybody about to be like, Neezy!
Which girlfriend would you be?
I don't know. I don't say all of that shit because I'm just Nay. I'm Neezy.
Nick, okay, no. Everybody, when you watch any type of show, you root for characters that you identify with. So you can't say that.
I can't be just one girlfriend. I have
That's
to
fair.
Be a mix.
Then say that.
Because
say that then.
Because you show no I bougie. Like Maya, but Maya was a cheater and I never was a cheater.
You don't have to condone everything.
And Tony, I can, you know, resonate with Tony too because
you bougie.
I'm bougie as shit.
We know. We know that.
But I'm not
too bougie
uppity.
For, too
I'm
bougie
not
for
uppity
Popeyes.
Like
yes, you is.
I'm not you too bougie like for how Popeyes. Tony was.
You too bougie for Popeyes. You ain't trying to stab a nigga for these Popeyes nuggets.
Because I just make my own damn fucking nuggets.
They're not going to taste the same, bro. They will. You got to have Harriet from Reba's house come over and put the Creole sauce on it so it got that Louisiana fresh.
I can buy the Creole sauce from Kroger.
Yeah, whatever. You ain't got it like that. Black Widow. So we did watch Black Widow. Thoughts?
Now.
Because you the Marvel expert now.
I am a huge Marvel fan. And I love me some Scarlett Johansson.
Yeah.
And now one, of course, we know that they had to give us a prequel because, sadly, we know she died in Endgame.
What? For real? When?
I'm really pissed about that. But that's, you know, that's a story for another time.
But you know this movie is like 10 years late, for real. Like, exactly. They should have been showed this. They could have canceled out one of them Hulk movies for
exactly.
this.
Exactly. We could have been had this movie. Because if you're going to now introduce, and I mean, I get this is what Marvel Phase 4 that they're trying to put us into. And they're basically, I did this movie to introduce the sister and the father and all of that.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
Anyways. we really don't care about them.
They did too much about, they should have shown more of her. I feel
more
like.
Of her because, but again, you got to look at it from the other side. They're trying to give us more of the mom, the dad, and the sister because she's gone. So they're trying to push it off like this is going to be the next story. Yes, this was Natasha's family. This is how Natasha was brought up.
Man, we no longer have Natasha's family.
You know? But I really don't care about her sister.
I would rather see Tony Stark's daughter grow up than to watch her sister with that silly ass vest. It has so many pockets. Yeah.
And honestly, I expected a little bit more because it's Natasha's story. Mm-hmm. I really expected more. Like, yes, we knew her that she was a spy.
They could have showed more of that. Show more of her coming up.
Yes, give me that. I don't need all of this busting the dad out of jail, blase, blase. I don't care.
That was a shitty ass escape plan, too.
It was.
But, like, she mentioned that, you know, her and Hawkeye was on the run in Budapest and all this and that. Like, show us that. Y'all could have flashed back to that. You know what I'm saying? And showed us how she maneuvered through that.
Give us those scenes, like what they did and what she did before she was trying to get, when she was trying to go pick up Hulk and she was trying to calm him down and get him in the thing.
Yeah.
Show us like what she did before then. Right. You know what I mean? Don't give a damn about.
Let me ask you this. How much did you see them try to, like, I don't want to say shoehorn, but it felt like they tried to turn it into a Me Too thing because my man's basically was pimping out all the Black Widows.
Yeah.
He was basically a red-blooded pimp. He had this little red mist and he was up there. Because it was exposing sex trafficking.
It was.
And prostitution, except they was killers, quote unquote. They wasn't no mm-hmm. good killers, though. Like, they was trying to make it like they was just elite.
They was not.
They was trash. I'm like, they trained them up like that? They was missing? I'll be on Call of Duty with my kill death ratio. I don't want to point.
They little training cap that they had looked trash.
They was in there like a black exploitation karate montage.
It was trash. It was really trash. But then the dude,
would you enroll in they spy?
Fuck no.
You don't want to shoot niggas fuck and dive no. off
they,
a building?
It wasn't even believable though. It was just like, this is a movie, you know.
I mean, that's, yeah.
But you know, some movies they'd be like, that shit could happen in real life. They got that over there, you know, mm-hmm. over there on their little island,
yeah.
little prison that they got over there in the snowbank.
Yeah.
But all of that shit, and then him, it was like, we get that he's supposed to, the father, he's supposed to be all super strong, but bruh, you trying to escape? If you could run and just bust doors and shit down like that,
walked out.
I would have walked. You could have walked out a long time ago.
Well, apparently he could have been tranquilized. So,
uh-huh.
He ain't got the moves no more, man. It's like, did you see that video of, I think I sent it to you, of Omarion dancing on stage? And they was like, this nigga ain't even dancing for real. He just doing shit.
Yeah, Omarion just be moving side to side and just spinning. And that's all he doing. Y'all be, ah, oh my God, Omarion.
Touch.
Because honestly, he's washed.
What?
They are washed at this point.
That last
they not, just trying
Usher
to come
not
back.
Washed. You talk about a nigga with the same two moves.
Usher just coming back showing us all his damn kids.
I'm gonna set my shoes on fire. Just really get them. Remember we was in Vegas that time?
They did that at the iHeart.
That's what I'm saying. Dog was up here. We went to the iHeart Music Festival, y'all, and Usher was on stage with his little tired ass dance moves. It was
Remember he was competing against Chris Brown. Yeah, so Chris Brown, that's why he had to set his fucking shoes on fire.
He should have started that. He should have led with that. Just set his shoes on fire and walked off the stage and let Chris Brown just have it, because Chris Brown smoked that nigga. Chris Brown. Yeah. This was I don't want to say pre-coke, because he was on coke, but he wasn't coked all the way out. He didn't have a sunken jaws like how he do now.
Yeah, nah.
So he was still athletic.
2013.
Yeah, he was spinning on his head, Chris Brown. Now he's spinning on his head, but he ain't getting back up. Like his nose
he's
bleed.
He's really
after
coked
his,
out, Chris Brown. Yeah. Nah,
his nose bleed when he spin on his head. Now that's the difference.
Yeah, now he just making music. Like when you say just doing shit, that's what he doing now. Just doing shit.
Ooh, I wanted to ask you this real quick, because then we gotta get out of here because I'm hungry. Pilots, they offer, like, there's a shortage in pilots. They paying $274 an hour.
That's good for those folks that want to fly them planes.
Are you with that?
Fuck no.
Why not? Remember that time when we was coming back from San Francisco and we couldn't get a pilot? I would have been like, I can fly this plane.
Yeah, nah. I ain't doing that shit. Because then they're throwing y'all in these damn quick, fast, these speed courses to fly these fucking planes.
Crashing them.
And then y'all gonna be like fucking Denzel off a flight.
Flying that bitch upside down.
Exactly.
Oh, man.
Fuck no.
I seen you fly a plane on Grand Theft Auto.
Fuck no.
You're trash.
I was finna say, you seen me fly the damn plane?
We had a good ass mission. It was doing fine. And then somehow you ended up upside down and in the ground.
I don't know how the hell. I don't know.
Upside
man.
Down.
I was flying
me,
straight. And then that shit just started turning. And I'm like, no.
You had
and
the controls down, but the physics was just off. And then you was like, I'm landing it. And I was like, babe, you gotta slow down. And you did not slow down. I said, I thought you
I
was,
did. I pushed the button to slow down.
I told you gotta hover and circle like how a real airplane does. And you like what, and then just crashed it into the side of a mountain. We lost like $230,000 on like cargo on Grand Theft Auto 5. I was so pissed, like, man, bro, nah. Circle around, like, do like how you see the regular people. And it was an easy mission too. I'm mad all over again.
Yeah, but nah, y'all gonna see folks out here that's like, yeah man, I used to be an accountant, but now I'm a pilot. Oh man, I used to be a store manager.
These planes,
but now I'm a pilot.
These planes is easy now, though. Most of it is just autopilot.
Yes, they fly themselves. But you also still got to be able to pull up when you need to.
Man, you don't need
so
to do
you
shit.
Get somebody in
it. It pulls itself.
Also,
it's like a Tesla plane.
Y'all know me, I'm an overthinker. You get somebody in there who's the crazy ass person that's just like, you know what? Fuck it. I just want to end it today. Push the button. Boop. And then bum, 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 bum. Then what's the famous line that every time you see a movie, pull up, pull up, pull up, and he'd be like, fuck no. Air
traffic
controller.
That's why you have a co-pilot, bro.
Okay, but what if he didn't did something to the co-pilot? We see this in movies all the time.
Here we go. I don't know. I think ever since 9/11, they got safety measures and stuff in place. I could be wrong. I don't know.
Yeah, well, probably, because we do know that these planes fly themselves.
Bro, do you want this $274 an hour or
I'm
not?
I'm good on it. All money I told you, good I'm money? Good on it.
I'll take it. Where I sign up at?
Fuck no. And then you're going to get
Kenny
your little,
at?
You're going to get your chip in your brain, and you're going to be, I am low. I can fly this plane.
Shit. Are they paying, though? You're not. We have babies now. We got a baby now. Mm-hmm. So you, nigga, I need that money.
You're
going to
be out here like the rest of these folks with that COVID vaccine. Oh, y'all going to all be zombies.
No, don't talk about them like that. You're not caring about everybody else because you didn't get the vaccine.
Y'all going to be zombies.
Shit. Y'all going to get shot. Well, it could go either way, though, because it could be the people who got the vaccine don't turn into zombies, and then the people who didn't get it are you know what I'm saying? Like we end up being the zombies and then they not, or they could be the zombies. If I'm end up being a zombie, I'ma get y'all. Like, yeah. Just be clear. So, but if I end up not being a zombie, I'm still gonna get y'all. You feel me? Like, so whichever side I get drafted to, like, it's on. Exactly. I just want you to know it's survival now. Like,
exactly.
If I got to do like how on your show where my man's like killed the zombies and smeared the blood on him. I already told you I smeared breast milk on my face.
So you can walk with them?
Yeah. Like, I'll walk amongst you, nigga. Go back to your little zombie hive, nigga, and wipe all your niggas out. I'm going to be at the gun range. Check me out. Talk about Father's Day gifts. All right. Anything else before we get up out of here? I'm hungry. My stomach's growling.
No, just thank y'all, because, shit, we've been getting orders left and right.
Orders!
Thank you for ordering your Naturally Nay Instant Moisture Duos.
Thank you. Come again, please.
Again, you can find us on Instagram at naturally_nay with two E's. And you can also go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay and order it there.
And go to inaudibleruckus.com/shop. We got some new merch that's going to be dropping. Give me about a week or two. And then midnightclubmerch.com, also Muse Lux Aesthetics Beauty Studios, and then Gross Power Washing and Cleaning. You can hit them up as well. It's been another episode of the Skeeters Minisodes.